They have agreed for a visa-free travel. In fact, all the our major points concerning the pilgrims, they have, I could say in broad terms, they have been broadly agreed. For example, visa-free travel is there, and then 5,000 they have committed in the first go, with an assurance that additional numbers would be considered gradually as they increase capacity, and we continue to pursue that. And throughout all days, the round the clock, all the 365 days of the year, that was an important requirement for our pilgrims. That has been agreed to. And our another request was, considering the number of visitors, the Indian persons of Indian origin who come to Darbar Sahab, and given their family connections, it was an important requirement that OCI card holders should also be allowed. So that has been agreed to. So from the perspective of pilgrims, I think a fairly good amount of accommodation has been made. I think it's significant and substantial. That's not part of that. It's not part of the talk. Yeah, it's a dawn to dusk. That had been already agreed in the first round of talks. It's a dawn to dusk. It's a day visit, and in the interest of our pilgrims and in the interest of smooth passage, we have considered it to keep it as a day visit. So that is already agreed upon. Dawn to dusk. Sorry? Yeah, they have given indications that this number should go up. The additionality they would consider depending on the capacity. And from our side, we have persisted with the request that additionality in terms of 5,000 is the bare minimum on normal days. And additional 10,000 on the special occasions, again, and minimum 10,000 should be an additionality. That request we have persisted, and we are going to continue persisting. But they have indicated that additionalities would be considered in due course, depending gradually with increase in capacity on their side. But we'll continue to push for the our original requirements only.
Sir,
देखिए, सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न हम पहले भी कहते रहे हैं और अभी भी कह रहे हैं कि सिक्योरिटी हमारे लिए पैरामाउंट कंसर्न है, और इस पर कहीं कोई लेटअप, चाहे इस तरफ से चाहे उस तरफ से, इसकी कोई संभावना है नहीं. हमारी एजेंसी पूरी तरह से इसमें कमिटेड है. तो आज भी, जैसे पहले के टॉक में किया था, आज के भी टॉक में किया है, सिक्योरिटी के मामले में हमारी कंसर्न्स को बहुत पुरजोर तरीके से रखा गया है. हमने जैसे आपको बताया, एक डॉसियर दिया है, उसके साथ सिक्स फॉर जस्टिस, आपको 10 तारीख को, आपको ध्यान में होगा, 10 जुलाई को, अभी चार दिन पहले, केंद्र सरकार ने जीरो टॉलरेंस की पॉलिसी अपनी अगेंस्ट एनी काइंड ऑफ सेसेशनिस्ट और एनी काइंड ऑफ मिलिटेंट एक्टिविटीज़ के खिलाफ टोटल जीरो टॉलरेंस पॉलिसी को डेमोन्स्ट्रेट करते हुए अभी चार दिन पहले फिर से एक उन्होंने कदम लिया है. एंड वी हैव ڈکلیئرڈ دی نیو یارک بیسڈ, ایک یہ فارن بیسڈ آرگنائزیشن ہے, چند لوگوں کی ایک فارن بیسڈ آرگنائزیشن ہے, نیو یارک بیسڈ ہے, اس کے چار لوگ کناڈا, چار لوگ یو کے, تھوڑے تھوڑے لوگ ہیں, اینڈ دے آر کیرنگ اینڈ آن لائن کیمپین اگینسٹ انڈیا, اسپریڈنگ ڈس افیکشن اگینسٹ پنجاب, اگینسٹ دا گورنمنٹ ایز اے ہول, اینڈ پلیڈنگ فار سیسیشنزم. تو وی ہیو بینڈ دیٹ آرگنائزیشن, ہم نے اس سنستھا کو ان لافل گھوشت کیا ابھی 10 جولائی کو, اس کا گجٹ نوٹیفیکیشن ہم نے ان کو دیا ہے اور ہم نے کہا ہے کہ ہمیں خبر ہے کہ آپ یہ سنستھا آپ کے یہاں بھی آپریٹ کر رہی ہے, پنجاب اسٹیٹ ان پرٹیکولر اینڈ پورے دیش ان جنرل, پورے دیش کے ہت کے خلاف ہے, یہ پنجاب کے خلاف ہے, پورے دیش کے ہت کے خلاف ہے, ہماری پالیسی زیرو ٹالرنس کی ہے اور اس طرح کی سنستھاؤں کے کسی طرح کی کریا کلاپ کو ہم بالکل برداشت نہیں کریں گے.
سر, دس از سمیت سنگھ فرام ٹی وی 9 بھارتورش, اینڈ مائی کوئسچن از ویری مچ پرٹیننگ ٹو دی سیم تھنگ.
یو ہیو سیڈ دیٹ ڈوزیئر ہیز بین گیون ٹو دی تان اسپیسیفکلی اباؤٹ دی سیپریٹسٹ ایلیمنٹس ہو ورکنگ دیر, اینڈ دیر از لاٹ آف نیوز کمنگ ان اباؤٹ ریفرینڈم 2020, the propaganda that is going on the Pakistani side. So specifically I just want to ask that you mentioned in your briefing an assurance about like any anti-India activity to be allowed. What is the stand of government of India? Do you trust the assurance is being given in these meetings by the government of Pakistan?
I didn't get your last question, last sentence, sorry. No,
do you trust the assurances specifically being given about these anti-India activities being done on the land of Pakistan?
See, today this was a joint secretary, this was a bilateral forum where it was our job to clearly highlight the concerns on behalf of the government, our government. So that we have done in very emphatic terms. We have given them detailed information. We have sought confirmation that individuals like Girish Chawla Gopal Singh Chawla have indeed been removed from the bodies where we had objection to. So they gave us a confirmation in the meeting. They provided the confirmation that Gopal Singh Chawla has been removed from the Prabandhak committee and other bodies where we had an objection. They provided us a confirmation, and they did give an assurance today that they will take note of the material we have provided them, the dossier, the gazette notification ban outlawing these Sikh for justice, and that they would act on it. So we'll definitely keep things under close watch, we'll follow up on whatever we have said today. There is no let up on these accounts, as I said, and we'll follow up on this, we'll keep a very close watch on how things evolve.
Sir,
Mr. Salil
Khanna,
Republic
TV. I am
I have no information. When we went to the committee, this was right now on my agenda. So about seeking, we had earlier also through a demarche issue to Pakistan, we had sought this specific action from them, which they have complied. For any subsequent thing, if something has happened, we'll consult our agencies and take it up suitably through our mission.
Here I would like to show the progress of the work that is going on both on the national highway and the passenger terminal complex. I would request Manish Rastogi ji, the chief general manager of the National Highway Authority of India, to throw some light on this.
Friends, as you know, Kartarpur corridor, Dera Baba Nanak corridor was inaugurated by Vice President of India on 20th,
out of which around 6 are complete and 2 is in progress. You can see on the left right section, we are achieving our normal height of the road.
We have just concluded the second round of talks with Pakistan on the modalities of operationalization of the Kartarpur Sahib corridor. Our delegation comprised of representatives from Home Ministry, External Affairs Ministry, Defense Ministry and Government of Punjab and National Highway Authorities of India, the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. As you are all aware, the first round of discussions on this issue were held on 14th March 2019. This was followed by 3 technical round meetings, where both sides discuss the technical issues related to road alignment and the finished road level, etc., and the how the overall infrastructure, road, etc., to be aligned at the border. The meeting today has reviewed the progress reached in the previous three rounds of technical meetings and has also built up on the progress made in the first round of talks, joint secretary level talks. In our meetings, we have endorsed the crossing point, the 0 point coordinates that were agreed to at the technical level. We have very importantly conveyed our concerns regarding the possible flooding of the Dera Baba Nanak and adjoining areas on our side as a result of the earth-filled embankment road or causeway that Pakistan side was proposing to be built across the Budi Ravi, the old Ravi Creek. So to highlight our concerns, we've provided a detailed flood analysis to Pakistan today to underscore these concerns, that these are real concerns and they have to be properly addressed. We have clearly conveyed that an earth-filled embankment or even a causeway as an interim measure that will create problems for our people, the habitations, the fields on our side, and that should not be built even in the interim. We have shared the details of the bridge that we are already building on our side. We have briefed you earlier, we have shown you the progress already made, and we have urged Pakistan to also build the bridge on their side so that they match the bridge on this side. Pakistan has agreed to build a bridge, although they have said that they would build it at the earliest. They have said that this particular year they are running short of time, so while they have agreed to build a bridge at the earliest, they have said that this year, due to time constraint, they would be unable to do so. So pending the construction of the bridge, and because we want that the 550th anniversary should take off on the is going to take off on the 12th November. So as purely as an interim measure, our side has agreed to a kind of a interim, the use of an interim kind of access in November onwards through the use of a slip road or a suitable service lane. But the bridge will be eventually be built from their side. We'd of course finish the bridge from our side at the scheduled time. So given the historical occasion, we would like this, and we are now sure that the event will commence on 12th November. And in the interim, we are going to provide for this slip road and interim kind of access on both sides. We had detailed discussions on the draft agreement as to the other modalities of this operationalization of the corridor. We have urged Pakistan to take into consideration the sentiments of the pilgrims for smooth, easy, hassle-free and unrestricted access throughout the year so that they are able to visit the holy Gurdwara Kartarpur Sahib. In this context, we have reiterated our request that 5,000 pilgrims be allowed to visit Gurdwara Kartarpur Sahib using the corridor every day, given the expected high demand on our side. We have also reiterated the request that 10,000 additional pilgrims, at least 10,000 additional pilgrims, be allowed to visit on special occasions, and that there should be no restrictions on the pilgrims in terms of their faith. Not only Indian nationals, but also persons of Indian origin who are holding OCI cards should be allowed to visit the Gurdwara Kartarpur Sahib. That request has also been reiterated in keeping with the stated announcement that the movement would be visa-free. Pakistan should reconsider charging any kind of a fees or introducing any kind of a restrictive system, whether in the name of a special permit or any other name. We have requested that pilgrims should be allowed to visit throughout the year, as is the practice in all other holy sites, and 7 days a week. We have also requested that pilgrims should have the choice to visit as individuals or in a group. They should be allowed to visit on foot if they so wish, and that provisions should be made And this is very important from our point of view, because considering the large number of pilgrims who will be visiting, we have emphatically requested that provision should be made for preparation and distribution of langar and prasad when the pilgrims visit the holy Gurudwara. So these arrangements should be in place by that time. These proposals are based on the request that we have received from the Sikh community, both within and outside the country, and we have emphasized this request. We also underscored the importance, and this is very critical to us, we have underscored the importance of ensuring safe and secure environment for the pilgrims. We have shared our concerns. We have several concerns in this regard, and we have shared our concerns regarding individuals or organizations which are based in Pakistan who may try to disrupt the pilgrimage and misuse the opportunity to play with the sentiments of the pilgrims. We have today handed over a detailed dossier from our side to highlight our concerns in the matter, which contain information about these organizations and individuals which may pose a kind of a potential threat to our pilgrims, and we have handed over this information with the request that they should seriously act upon them. We have also sought, for the benefit and for the facilitation of our pilgrims, a consular presence in Kartarpur Sahib Gurudwara, so that we are able to provide regular assistance to our pilgrims who will be going there on a daily basis. Pakistan side has assured our delegation, in response to the request made, that no India anti-India activity will be allowed by them. We have, based on the representations that we have received from the government, once again, there are several representations have been received by the government, so based on that, we have once again raised the issue of encroachment and acquisition of land which belongs to the holy Gurudwara. This is linked to the sentiments of the people, and in that light, we have requested the Pakistan side to honor the sentiment, the religious sentiment associated with the lands in the name of the Gurudwara and Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji, and we have requested them that they should immediately remove the encroachments, restore the encroached land to the Gurudwara, and they should also make arrangements to restore the land which has reportedly been acquired also through the official departments. They have acquired also, they have reportedly acquired some land, that also should be restored as soon as possible. But the encroached land should be entire lot of it should be immediately restored to them. We have today made, I'm happy to tell you that on our side, as you are also aware, we have made significant efforts to build a state-of-the-art infrastructure, including passenger terminal on our side, which can handle, which has the capacity to handle 15,000 pilgrims a day. This is targeted to be completed by 31st October 2019, both the passenger terminal building and the highway connecting it. And we are absolutely confident that we'll be able to, our agencies will accomplish this well in time. The work on the four-lane highway to the crossing point at the international border is progressing at a fast pace, and this is on schedule. And this is, in fact, expected to be completed even a month earlier, by September 2019. We are therefore fully confident that we would be ready to commence the pilgrimage through Kartarpur Sahib corridor on the auspicious occasion of 550th birth anniversary of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji. Today, in our second joint secretary level meeting, we have conveyed to the Pakistan side and sought their cooperation for the proposal of Sikh Gurudwara Prabandhak Committee and the Delhi Gurudwara Sikh Gurudwara Management Committee to take out Nagar Kirtan from Delhi to Nanakana Sahab in Pakistan. This was on the silence of the meeting, but being an important event, we have used this opportunity to highlight our request. We have also requested to Pakistan to allow a higher number of pilgrims, 10,000 Indian pilgrims, to visit Pakistan under the existing 1974 protocol on the occasion of this momentous, on this momentous occasion. Another request from SGPC regarding sending a group of 550 pilgrims to Gurudwara Nanakana Sahib on 23rd July 2019 to mark the year-long celebration of 550th birth anniversary of Sri Guru Nanak Dev Ji has also been taken up today with Pakistan. They have informed us that these requests will be duly considered, they are already under the consideration, and these will be accorded priority. today, to sum up, actually, we have been able to narrow down the differences in our respective positions since the first meeting held on 14th March 2019. Just to illustrate the key points, it was agreed to allow visa-free travel for not only Indian passport holders, of all faiths of course, so Indian passport holders, but also OCI card holders for all 7 days a week throughout the year. 5,000 pilgrims, they have at this stage, they have agreed to allow 5,000 pilgrims per day. Of course, our request for a higher number remains with them. We'll continue to pursue that. So these pilgrims can travel as individuals or in groups and also on foot. So these have been also agreed upon in the interest of the pilgrims. Pakistan side has, of course, highlighted their infrastructural constraints on their side and conveyed that they may be able to accommodate these additional numbers which we have sought based on the capacity available. The Kartarpur Sahib corridor is a long pending demand of the pilgrims, and we genuinely expect that, and we have expressed our expectation with the Pakistan side that they would be liberal in allowing more pilgrims and facilities for them through this corridor. Both sides have maintained we are going to maintain a channel of communication. We have agreed to maintain a channel of communication and work towards early finalization of the agreement on the modalities, especially considering that the day of the celebration is relatively close. Our technical teams would meet again to ensure a seamless connectivity for the Kartarpur corridor, and the details will be worked out based on the agreements reached today. The agencies would meet together and work out in detail the modalities. If it is required, if it is at all required, we hope we'll be able to finalize. But if at all it is required at a later stage, that two delegations could meet again in India for formally concluding the agreement, if at all it is required. But in the meanwhile, our agencies will try and work based on the progress made today to work out the details and try and conclude this all the operational arrangements. Thank you.
बस सामने से